Hey guys, so this video is for our 2nd through 4th grade team for March, week 3. This month our life app is forgiveness, deciding that someone who has wronged you doesn't have to pay. And our memory verse for the month is Colossians 3:13, put up with one another. Forgive one another if you are holding something against someone. Forgive just as the Lord forgave you. Lola, are you two team? Hey, no, thank you. Give me these. Okay, so far this month we have talked about forgiveness. We have learned about the unmerciful servant and we should forgive others because God forgives you. Last week we learned about Zacchaeus and when you forgive others, it can change them. Well, this week we're going to hear the story of Jesus teaching on forgiveness, and our bottom line is take the first step to forgive others. So just a little bit more detail about what the story is going to be about this week. It says, Jesus brought his followers to a mountain to explain to them what it means to live as part of God's kingdom. During that message, he said something important about forgiveness. In Matthew 5, 23 through 24, Jesus said, suppose you are offering your gift at the altar, and you remember that your brother or sister has something against you. Leave your gift in front of the altar. First, go and make peace with them. Then come back and offer your gift. We should seek to make things right with others before trying to worship God. So our bottom line is, take the first step to forgive others. Forgiveness is important to God, and if we are in a difficult situation with someone, we should seek to make it right with them. So while there are some relationships that might never fully be restored, we can at least try to offer and show forgiveness to others in our life. Lola, leave those there. Okay, so jumping into our leader guide, we would love for you to join us in the garage room at 8:20 and 10:20 for prayer. It just sets our hearts and minds up right for serving that day. Also, it allows us an opportunity to pray for each other. Then just make sure that you are in your small group by 8:30 and 10:30 so that you got everything ready to go. When kids start to roll in, this is leftover from a previous month. You do not need that. When kids start to roll in, just make it personal. Welcome all kids and ask how their week was. Make sure you know everyone's name. Help new guests feel welcome and comfortable. No, thank you. Then you are going to gather kids on one side of your small group area and stand several feet away, and you're going to play small group leader, may I? Kind of like mother, may I? So kids will take turns asking you questions like, small group leader, may I take three big hops? And you can answer either yes, you may, or no, you may not. And the kids can replace small group leader with your actual name. If you choose to answer no at a qualifier, like no, you may not, only kids wearing red shirts may take three big hops. And then you're going to play until at least one child reaches you, and then you can just repeat as many times as you would like. When service starts at 9 and 11, all the kiddos are going to have a pencil. I meant to order St. Patrick's Day pencils off Oriental Trading, and I forgot. So I'm going to go by the dollar store and see if they have any, but we will figure out some kind of fun pencil. So you're going to gather kids to stand around and spread out as much as possible in your small group area, and then you're going to give each kiddo a pencil to balance on their head. And then you're just going to play some music from your phone, and as the music plays, kids are going to walk around your small group area balancing the pencils on their heads. If a pencil falls, they have to freeze and they can't move again until another friend picks up their pencil for them. So the friend who helps may hold his own pencil in place with his hand while helping the friend. And then you're just going to stop the music at regular intervals to allow kids to reset their pencils and then just keep playing. So it's just kind of a silly game, and you're going to say, if you drop the pencil in this game, what happened? Yeah, you couldn't move until someone stopped to help you. Well, in our Bible story today, we're going to learn about how stepping up can make a big difference in our relationship with others. So then you'll head across the hall to large group. This week for large group, we have a live host, but we will be watching the video for the story. When you get back from small group, our review activity is called One Step Forward, Two Steps Back. So you have, you're going to have all these little sit spots on your cart. And you're going to, they're Velcro, so they stick to the carpet. Excuse me, Lola. We have this get up on today. These Christmas pajamas with these cowboy boots. We are looking good. You're going to arrange these sit spots in like a little snake, you know, arrangement on the floor. You're going to have 20 of them for each group. And you have a dice. And you have these little forgiveness scenarios. They look like this, only they'll be cut apart. So what kids are going to do, you're going to divide them into two teams. You're going to use the sit spots to create a life-size game board, laying out the 20 circles in a serpentine pattern. You're going to designate the first circle as start and the last circle as finish. You're going to shuffle the forgiveness scenarios and keep them face down. And then you're going to pick a child with the closest birthday to today to go first, or however you want to pick the first player. They're going to roll the dice and move the appropriate number of spaces on the board. And then they're going to select a card, read the scenario, and move forward or backward depending on what the card says. So, for example, one of the cards might say, your friend says something unkind and you say something mean back. Move backward two spaces. Okay, then you're going to continue to allow kids from each team to take turns rolling the dice and moving that number of spaces, drawing a card, and then moving forward or backward. You're going to encourage kids to make room for everyone as they move through the board. There will likely be a few times when kids end up on the same space. That's fine. And the first team to get one player to the finish line is the winner. So you're going to finish this out by saying, so why do you guys think you had to move backwards when this scenario was an example of someone refusing to forgive? How is moving forward in this game like a picture of what happens when we take steps to forgive? In each of these scenarios, something happened that either wasn't fair or was hurtful. It's natural when we're hurting to want to hurt the other person back or to stay angry, but that won't fix it. Jesus tells us that forgiveness comes first. Do just one thing to help fix the relationship and to take a step toward the other person. That can mean you save them a seat at lunch, even though they said they wouldn't be your reading partner today, but then they pick somebody else. Or it can mean that you let your brother borrow a few Lego pieces, even though he lost them last time. Let's make sure that we take the first step to forgive others so we can protect our relationship with the people around us. Then for the memory verse activity, you are going to look up and review Colossians 3:13 together. Then you're going to cut four pieces of just regular blank paper in half to create eight cards. You're going to pass the cards out and let kids work together to write out three words of the verse on each card. And the last card might not have three words on it. That's fine. Oh, excuse me, I just swallowed my spit. Okay. When they're finished, you're going to collect the cards. You pooped? Great. When they're finished, you're going to collect the cards and spread them out on the floor in verse order. You can tape them down if you'd like. And you're going to make sure the cards are far enough apart so that the kids have to take big steps to get from one set of words to the next. You're going to line kids up at the end of one of the verse cards. And you're going to let kids take turns stepping from one card to the next as they say the words of the verse out loud. And then just make sure that one kid gets all the way from start to finish before the next kid starts, and repeat until all the kids have had a turn to walk the path and recite the verse. And you'll close this down by saying, so our verse reminds us to forgive when we're holding something against someone. Why is it better to forgive than to stay mad or try to prove that we're right? Let kids answer that question. When we take steps towards forgiveness, we have a better chance of fixing what's broken. In fact, it's so important that Jesus says we should try to fix the relationship even before we worship him. So when you're tempted to stay mad, ask God to help you choose to forgive instead. He will always help us take the first step to forgive others. Okay, excuse me, cowboy boot girl. Then you got some optional discussion questions. Is it hard? When is it hard to forgive someone? What can keep us from forgiving someone? What are things people do when they hold a grudge? What have you learned that can help you take the first step to forgive? How can knowing that we are all created in God's image help you to forgive others? And then just to close down in prayer, you're just going to gather the kids in a tight circle with their knees bent and their feet flat on the floor in front of them. So like this, okay, if that makes sense. And then you're going to encourage kids to put their hands on their shoes as you pray that God would help them to take the first step to forgive others this week. So then you'll just close down in prayer, and that's it. Thank you guys so much for coming and being small group leaders. You are all truly amazing. I am so, so thankful for each and every one of you. Thank you for being here every single Sunday and for just pouring into the lives of the next generation. You guys are amazing, and I'm so thankful for you, and I will see you on Sunday.